topic. So today we'll see path call by reference or path by reference. So in call by value method we saw that how the copy of the variable is moved to the function. Okay. And how the function does not have access to the original variables. The original variables that are actual parameters, those are untouched. Okay. Only in the function, only the copies, okay, we could work on the copies only. So that means this type of call by value situation, when they are actually useful. Okay, so this call by value method is useful when we don't want to change the value in the calling method. So we don't want to disturb the variables in the calling method. Okay, then we take this approach, call by value method. Okay, call by reference on the other hand, okay, uses a different mechanism. So here the value of the copy is not passed, rather the reference to the variable is passed. A reference, an address, okay, that is only passed to the method. Okay, so reference means what? The address, the memory location, that is only transferred to the method. So and actually here in Java we don't find out the address, don't find out the location of the variable, okay, explicitly. Means we are not finding the address of the variable ourselves. Rather Java provides us facility to give facility to create reference variables, like a class variable. When you create, that is a reference variable. I have told so many times, honest, student x is a reference variable. So it is nothing but it has some address. Okay. So Java provides us to have reference variables. So we don't have to create those our own. Okay, here also the same concept is there. You have formal parameter and actual parameters. Okay, here actually formal parameters and actual parameters you have. Here actually the formal parameters, they are the reference variables. They are the references to the actual parameters. if the actual parameter is an object, okay, that can be assigned to a formal parameter. Okay, now we have, you know that Java has 8 primitive types, okay, and those 8 primitive types, they can be passed as passed by value, and actually all others are Java's reference types, and they are all passed by reference, okay. Now you can see one program where you have two primitive variables of int type, x and y. X stores 10, y stores 20. And the program's name is demo fn calls. It is for swapping. Swapping the two values. Okay. So see, in the main method, actually here the main method is demo test function. Here it shows the x and y passed, then swap call by value function is called. The swap call by value function, as you know, it takes the two variables, x and y. That means their value will be passed to the method. Look at the method is down. Okay, that is swap call by value method. Here, the x and y, their values are received, okay, in A and B, okay, and how the value are exchanged with the help of a temporary variable. Temporary variable is the TMP here. TMP for some time is storing the value of A, so that A value is secure, okay. So PMP is storing the value of A so that for some time A value is secured or set. Now you can change the value of A because in this program, in this method, swap call by value method, here the variables are not x and y, they are recognized as a and b. So a can be changed. Okay. Now b also you can change because that a value you have stored in TMP. Now that you can assign to b. So because of these three assignment statements, the value of A and B, okay, it's swapped. The values are swapped. Now, in this time method, you are seeing the, okay, what is it, recent value of A and B, that will be how much? See, x and y were assigned 10 and 20. Now in the swap call by value method, they will be shown what? 20 and 10. And the swap call by value method, when it is over, then you are in the demo test method again. You are seeing again through this println function x and y you are showing, but you are getting the same thing, 10 and y, 10 and 20. Or not? There is no change. Okay. But now you will do in this same demo test method, in this main method, you will do the call by reference. So for that, you need a reference variable. Reference variable, as you know, can be created using the class name. So we are using the demo fn calls class to create a reference variable object 1. Object 1 is storing the reference to a new object. Okay. And now swap call by reference, call by ref method is called. Now object 1 is passed. You see, your actual variable is a reference variable. Sorry, actual argument is an object or a reference variable. So now that is passed. Now you see the swap call by ref in the down, it is defined. There it is receiving. It is again another object, OBJ of that type. Another demo fn calls. See, demo fn calls type reference variable. Only that type of reference variable can refer to the object of that type. Okay. Now see, so in this method, OBJ is the, OBJ is again referencing to the object which was in the main method. Yes or no? Because object 1 was referring to that object, now OBJ also is referring to that object. So you can change it here, change the contents of the that object in the main class, the main method, that object in the main method from here, from this sub method, okay, directly. You can change that object. That object was created in the main method. That object's property you can change here. That object attributes you can change here in this swap call by ref. See, OBJ is simply a reference variable. See, suppose OBJ object 1 in the main method, object 1 was also a reference variable, was pointing to the object. Okay. Now, that was happening in the main method. But in the sub method, see, that is swap call by ref, it is received. Okay, now this is assigned to object 1 is assigned to OBJ. So now again, OBJ is what? OBJ is a reference variable of same type as that is of what? Yes. As the object 1 is of the demo fn calls, as the object 1 is a reference variable of demo fn calls. Okay, OBJ also is a reference variable of demo fn calls, same class, yes or no? So ठीक दिस कैन रेफर टू एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ दैट टाइम दैट क्लास टाइम ओबीजे ऑल्सो कैन रेफर ओके सो नाउ व्हेन दिस ऑब्जेक्ट वन इज असाइन टू ओबीजे दैट मीन्स दिस एड्रेस द ऑब्जेक्ट एड्रेस ओके रियल ऑब्जेक्ट एड्रेस इज असाइन टू ओबीजे ओके प्रीवियसली यू वेर getting the attributes like object one dot something or not now you will get those attributes with obj dot something so in the swap call by ref method again tmp variable is there and it is used to change the means the object has two values, two attributes, x and y. So obj x and obj y are swapped. Okay, again with the help of tmp variable. And here in the method swap call by ref method you are showing them and again coming back from the method in the main method again you are showing them so in all cases you will get the 20 and 10 okay you will get the value 20 and 10 if it is changed in the method in the called method it is also changed in the main method okay that means originally the value is changed now you have another program this program converts distance in feet or inches using a call by reference method so you have some attributes here feet inches okay and they convert to feet and inches are feet is float type inches is integer and then converted to is string see class name is try so the constructor is try okay class name is try so the constructor is also try here by default these three values are stored hit 0 hit should be 0.0 okay 0.08 inches 0 and converted to mc you have another constructor that takes two things how many feet how many inches it takes okay in the formula parameter f and I and there is a figure assigned in the constructor to feet and inches now you see another class method static method that is convert to feet this convert to feet method takes an object and that object is again the same class object try object okay and when it takes it starts first it stores the inches in the variable y okay so inches you know, 12 inches is 1 feet. Yes or no? So first inches are converted to feet. So that is y by 12. That is from feet. And here you will still get some inches behind. Because left. Then because if you have 17 inches, you have supplied 17 inches to the object. Then y by 12 will give you 17 by 12. That means how many feet? 1 feet. Okay. Another 5 inches is left. How that is raised? Then you see x minus feet into 12. How many feet you get, you got, that into 12. Okay. Then original that inches minus that one. So you get now how many inches left. Okay. Now, so you have also second feet. Okay. So you have also taken this feet. Okay, that so here you can see it. You have taken how much inches and then feet. So think that INS is how, what? How many remaining? Why it is dividing by 10? To get some points. Okay. So F is equal to F plus that one. So F is equal to means 1 feet 5 inch. That is 1 feet 1.5. So, no, 17 inch suppose it is 17 inch, it will be 1.5. 23 inches means? 23 inches means it will be 1.11. It's so. Right? So it is wrong, no? Okay, some problem is there here. Okay. Now again, see, next one you see, 1/2 inches. It is also tracking the try object. In FPS, it is storing the obj.fit. And in INS, it is storing obj.inches. Now see, it is decreased into 12. FPS into 12. It will give how many inches? Now plus INS will you give you total how total number of inches? So you can return that total number of inches. Okay, it is okay. This one is okay. Actually that program convert to feet is not okay because see inches Actually, this intensity only stored. Whoop, heat is not stored. Okay. In the first one, you see, convert to peak program, intensity only stored. Heat is not stored. Then you have a distance method. Distance method is showing how many feet and how many inches. Okay, that is a string, and that string is returned. Now see, this is the main method, try test method. Try test method, it is giving 5 and 2. When it is creating the object, 5 and 2 is passed to the object. First, object pitch, object for pitch. Object for pitch is the means reference variable dot distance function. So, what it will show? 5. Okay, 5 feet and then 2 inches. Yes. Is equal to convert to inches will show how much? Convert to inches will be 62. Okay, 62. Now you see another object is created giving 0 and 16. So here the object for inches dot, it is the object name is the object for inches dot distance method is called, then object to feet is called. Okay, to give you the answer. Distance is how many feet. Okay. Next program. Be careful. I am seeing so many students talking nicely. So this program illustrates the difference between the two ways of invoking methods. Two way of invoking methods, that is pass by value and pass by reference. Okay. Okay, I'll say. So these are the line numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Whatever line numbers are there, okay, each line has a number before it. So see, again here, primitive data type in the demo test method. Primitive data type I method is called with I method. I method is called. Okay, the method, whose name is I method is called with the I. Next you see, a string buffer object is created. And another method is called SD method. And supplying the SD. But look at this, SD method is not getting the value or not returning any value. Okay. Still, when you will print the SD, okay, the SD method was taking one value, that is the SD. SD is the reference variable to a string buffer object. String buffer, actually string buffer means it is another kind of string. Okay. Another type of string class. Okay. The string of class So, you see, like you create string sp is equal to new string in the bracket hello world. Okay, just like that. String buffer is also created. String buffer sp is equal to new string buffer, okay, hello world. And the sp is the pass to the method. To the SB method. We look at the SB method. It is received as a string buffer variable. Here the variable is the SB test. You see, it is trying to insert Java in the seventh location. Because whether it is a string or string buffer object, the location starts with 012. There are some letters, and in the seventh location, Java is inserted. Java is inserted. Maybe something is I is there. You see, was there? What was there? Java was? Hey, Java world was there. Now Java is inserted. And when you will see in the method, in the SP method, you will see that the change also coming back from the method, you will also see the same change. Okay, the Java is inserted again here. Okay.